Hi there, my name is Tony Gregorius, reporter for the Angling Times, and today I've come down to Castle Ashby Fishery in Northamptonshire. Now this is a fantastic fishery all year round. It's got three lakes, but the lake at the moment that everyone's looking at is Scotland Pond. Now it's full carp up to £30 plus, but at the moment they're not even getting a look in, and it's the bream that are getting a look in. 30, 40 pound catches in matches, not even winning you a penny, and aren't getting you into the frame. And in a recent match, over 60 pound one with a load of backing weights around the 50 pound mark. And it's very simple tactics to catch them. Now there's quite a few anglers down here, well-known anglers who've been catching big weights, pleasure fishing and match fishing. But one man who we're with today is Joe Roberts. Now he's currently the Veterans World Champion, brought home gold for our country this year, and he's just to my right of me. So let's go and see how he's catching these big bags of bream.
Hi Tony,
mate?
How are you?
Good to see you, mate. How are you doing today? You catching a few?
I've had a few, got 7 or 8, maybe 9, I'm not sure. It's a bit slower today because of an easterly wind, but there's a few fish out there.
Excellent. Now tell us about this pond though, a little bit. You know, what peg are we on today?
Well, I'm on peg 13. It's been producing quite well in all the matches. The winner was on here on Wednesday. On Sunday, on the Winter League. On Wednesday it was second, so it's a good area. No point sitting on a bad nilla. It's much of a muchness to lake. It's very shallow, but this time of the year the fish tend to be this end of the lake, and then as it goes colder they move down to the slightly deeper water down in front of the lodge.
Fantastic.
But I just thought I'd come and have a little chuck today. Okay, so draw it in a winter league, you never know.
Good practice session.
Yeah, that's right.
Most of the fishing are out of pole range here, so obviously it's onto rod and line tactics. But talk specifically about your rig. I mean, if you could wind that in.
Yeah, sure, no problem.
I mean, so what are we using? Are we on a ground bait feeder?
Method feeder is king on this lake.
Brilliant. More and more the method feeder was seen as a carp and sort of tench tactic, but I'm sure you'd agree, Joe, becoming more and more versatile, isn't it?
Oh, without a doubt, without a doubt. Only a small method feeder.
Have you got any preference on the actual method you use or any brand you use?
I always use Gurus.
Right, and what's the reason behind that?
I just think they're very well made. They're the perfect weight at 24 gram for me. I've never had a problem. I like the pad on the top.
Yeah.
So you can, if you want to bury your bait, you bury the bait, and it sits on the pad, and you know it's not dropped inside a feeder like it could do on that one.
Yeah. Hey, so that's the Preston.
That's the Preston one. I only use these two: the Preston Innovation or the Gurus. But number one choice is a Guru.
Fantastic.
For me.
And talk us through your terminal tackle. You know, from main lines through to hook links and things like that. And if you could just explain your choice.
Well, it's very shallow. It's very shallow, and it's important that when you throw a method feeder out, it stays where it lands.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it defeats the object. So. The weight has to be right, but you also need a line that will sink quickly.
Yeah.
Because if you get a big boa line, it'll pull it, you know, it can pull a lighter feeder off position. I use 5 pound Maxima.
Yeah.
I'm a great believer in the old lines, being an old bloke. I've had this on for a while. It really does get better with age, line. I'm not saying keep it on for 3 years, but it needs to be used a few times. It sinks like a brick. It's perfect for me.
Brilliant. And then what about the danger range, shall we say?
It's so easy. I mean, I use a quick change attachment,
right?
Which is that, which you'll find in the carp department at most shops.
So we're using a fixed rig here then?
Yes, it's fixed. It's these Gurus are done to a black hydro.
Yeah.
It's fixed. And I'll just use that as a quick change attachment.
And I've noticed there, I mean, the actual Guru X Surf feeders, the elastic usually pulls through.
Yeah.
So it acts as kind of a hybrid feeder, isn't
it? Yeah, mine's. Every bit of kit I've got, I alter. I can't help it, it's just the way I am. And I alter these, I'll put a big split ring on the top. It does do away with the safety feature that I know that they built into Gurus, but it becomes the same as any other in-line rubbered up feeder that you buy on the market now.
You can just see that little ring on the top, and I guess that allows you just to clip on and off and change feeders as the day goes.
Yeah, another thing as well, when you get the 60, you need something big.
Yeah.
And it just clips on, and that's it. It will never come off, and it's perfect.
Excellent.
I use a 3-inch hook length. This is 017 N gauge in Guru, with an 18 Preston PR36.
Yeah.
I'll put a spike on, which is a metal spike. I don't know whether you want to see that.
And that's just a, and I'm guessing, what's the purpose behind that then, Charlie?
Well, for boilies, it's ideal. You just spike the boilie on, it's so easy. Nothing to go wrong.
So if we just demonstrate that, as we say, boilies, literally, we've got a little spike there, which hangs off on the hair rig, and then it's literally as simple as that. And that's impaled on there now, and then I'm guessing that won't come off, Joe.
No. No, okay. Well, I've just had four fish on the same boilie.
And that's, what are your favourite colours with boilies?
Well, personally, it's white. But I got here today and I've struggled a bit. The three or four fish I had early on yellow corn, which is yellow.
Yeah.
And then one of my mates has just come down, so I was on here Wednesday, I was second, I caught on yellow boilie.
Yeah.
So I put yellow boilie on, it's not stopped going round. So, just goes to show, it's...
I guess it just shows up ringing the changes every now
that's
and
right,
then.
Yeah, but yellow seems to be the bait today. Tomorrow it might be red. This is what you need to find out.
And we're just having a look here, you know, there's a variety of baits here. Just talk me through what we've got here. I mean, obviously we've got the boilies.
We've got the boilies. I always bring maggots, but I always freeze mine. I always have dead maggot. I never use live maggot.
And what's the reason behind that?
Because it won't fold over the hook.
Right.
That's the sole reason to it. No other reason I can think of. But
the point's always showing me in better hook hold.
Yeah, that's dead right. But the thing about dead maggots is, if you want to do them properly, some people boil it, scald them. Yep. But that takes the colour out of them. I don't. What I do is I buy them from the shop, I tie the bag up, the plastic bag, put it in the freezer, leave it 2 days.
Excellent.
That's it. But you must keep them in water like this.
And what's the reason behind that?
Because they deteriorate very, very quickly if they're not in water.
Excellent.
They go black and horrible. The other thing is obviously sweet corn, which I said I caught on earlier. And that there is polony meat, which has been a good bait.
Just a little bit tougher than luncheon meat, am I right?
It's a bit more buoyant.
That's the benefit of it.
That's the benefit of it. It's very easy. It float, you know, when a bream comes along and sucks about on this,
fantastic.
It will lift.
And you mentioned that, you point to this. This here is what goes around the feeder. Well, what have we got here then?
I've got a
box of goodies in front of me.
Right, let me put that out there out of the way.
Can you talk me through what we've got here?
Right, I do a mix of these two ground baits.
So
they're both fishmeal ground baits. I know what's in them, so I'm happy to use those.
And what are these ones? What's the name of these?
Right, this is Stimulate, Sensor Stimulate. I've had a lot of success with this over the last 2 years. And this one is Crazy Bait Gold, which is an old tried and tested, one of my original ground baits. But it still takes some beating.
Excellent.
But this one is quite sticky ground bait.
Yeah.
Which you need to stick to the feeder. You have to vary the amounts you use for the depth of the water, because it's no good fishing in 10 foot of water, the feeder hitting the surface, everything coming off.
Seriously.
No point. It's so you know you vary your ground bait to get it right. Also, I have some. This is pure fish meal. I add a bit of this more in the warmer weather. It's got a bit colder today, so we've not put much in it at all. Yeah.
So, I mean, as I say, the ground bait field can be a real minefield in terms of what to pick. So just in a nutshell, what you said, the Crazy Bait Gold adds stickiness to keep it on. What does the Stimulate add?
The Stimulate is a crushed pellet mix.
Yeah.
This is pellet going in, so I want to get as much pellet in a little bundle as I can.
So I'm guessing it's what the fish see lots of.
That's right.
Give them plenty of.
That's right. All this will be... is that when it breaks down or any other crushed pellet based ground bait, you know.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So it's important to look at your ground bait, analyse what you're trying to do with it. Not just
what you need to do is work out what it's doing.
If you
come across something that works, if it works, that's the best thing in the world. If the tip goes round, it's working. Once you get there, then you can elaborate on it, and but you need to know why it's working. And if you know what you're using, then you've got more chance of working out why it's working.
And it was interesting you mentioned, we're only fishing like 2 to 3 foot of water today.
Yeah. Yeah.
And if that was, for example, if you're fishing a deep bream water where you've got 9 or 10 foot, would you alter the quantity?
I'd put more of the sticky ground bait, less of that.
Yeah.
And maybe less of the pellet.
Because I was just about to move on to then, it's not just the ground bait, is it? I mean, this mix here that is pellets coated in that mix of ground bait. So you've got a, it's almost a 50-50.
Yeah, the pellets the easiest thing in the world to do.
How do you do then?
When you get up in the morning,
yeah.
I put about a pint of pellets in a polythene bag.
Yeah.
And I fill it to about half inch above the pellets with water, cold water. Tie a knot, that's it. By the time the match starts, they're done. They've soaked all the water in and they're soft.
Excellent. Fantastic. Well, now we know the tactics there, and as we said, it's been a reasonably slow day, but there's been a few fish showing around there, so if we have a chuck, you think we might have a chance?
Yes, yes, you never know, we might get one.
Let's have a go at that one. Let's see how Joe does now.
Little one.